अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्विषे नमः। गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो नमः। भक्त्या विहीनापराधलक्ष्यै क्षिप्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्यै कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वन्दे नमस्ते चरणार। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि श्री गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल I am offering myself so many dandavat pranam and my heartly pushpanjali in the lotus feet of my holy master Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupasya Sumat Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj. Also in the same time I am offering my heartly pushpanjali in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru Sri Shila Bhakti Vedan Swami Maharaj. First of all, I want to say that in my last tour in Western countries, Holland, England, and America, Canada, and all other countries, I told first, though India is poor country, and I have come from India. But I have not come from poor India. I have come from a very healthy, wealthy and so rich country in Vedic culture and Krishna affection and love. So I have not come here to collect money, wealth, reputation and any worldly thing. But I've come to give the same object, same mission, and same wealth that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to this world. You have heard so much about Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupah Kadamayam Dadati Supadantikam. There are so many associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Advaita Acharya was there, Haridas Thakur was there, Srila Swarup Damodar Raya Ramanand were there. Also, Mahapandit, great learned person of Puri, Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya were there. So many were there. But why Narottam Thakur told that Sri Chaitanya Manobhishta Sthapitam by Rupa Goswami? Why? Haridas Thakur is Namacharya, given by himself Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Namacharya. Swarup Damodar was there, Raya Ramanand was there, so much learned, like teachers of Rupa Goswami. What Rupa Goswami has told only the topics and the same thing which Swarup Damodar and Raya Ramanand Prabhu has come to give. So, why Narottam Thakur told like this? you have heard before from in his lecture, and also Urukaram Prabhu and Govinda Bhakta. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has not come only to preach Harinam. His interior motive was not that. In so many Kaliyuga Yugas, lakhs and lakhs Kaliyuga, Advaitacharya Mahavishnu has done this. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu mission was not to give this, only this. Something man. And that was bhakti rasa, not bhakti. Before that, so many acharyas have given bhakti. Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, Nimbarkacharya, Vishnu Swami, so many has given this thing. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has not come only for this, to give bhakti. He has come to this world. Mane, who is he? Who is himself? Krishna. In Krishna Leela, in Dwapar Yug, he tested mainly all the five kinds of rasas. Especially, he tested gopis, madhur rasa. But he was not satisfied by that. He wanted to know why Srimati Radhika test me more than anyone, more than myself. Why she becomes mad for me? There are several devotees there. I also love Srimati Radhika, but I don't become mad for Srimati Radhika. But Radhika become mad. Why? How he tastes my beauty, my everything? Krishna is more beautiful, no? So much beautiful than Ram, Lakshmi, Narayan, and all other. But Srimati Radhika is so beautiful that Krishna has accepted him like his guru of love. But Krishna thinks that there is something in me that it attracts Srimati Radhika also. So if anyone has the same mood of Srimati Radhika, he can test more me, and he can serve more, and he can control me. So what I have in my beautiful body, in my all things, so if I will take the mood and beauty of Srimati Radhika, then I can test myself. What the thing is in me that it attracts whole world, even creatures, animals, trees, creepers, everything. Even clouds, even deers, even goddesses, devis, everyone. What is that? He could not taste it in Krishna Leela, pastime. So he took the beauty and mood of Srimati Radhika and became Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So the mercy of Srimati Radhika, mercy of Krishna combined came into Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So if we have no mercy from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we have no faith in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we cannot know Radha and Krishna who were there. What is love? Who is Jiva? Who is actually Guru? So everything we can know by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This mood, Srila Rupa Goswami has only described in his books. because he has empowered him in Prayag. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was returning from Vrindavan and going to Puri in the midway, on the bank of Ganges and Jamunas, where they are meeting, very sacred place, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu bestowed his all mercies in Srila Rupa Goswami. And he also told Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Acharya Haridas Thakur, Swarup Damodar, Raya Ramananda, Sikhi Maiti, Prabhu, learned person, Sarvam Bhattacharya, and all others, bestow your mercy to Rupa Goswami. That is why he was successful in getting all the modes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very easily. So, if anyone knows the aim and object of Sri Rupa Goswami, interior heart of Krishna and Radha Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, through Rupa Goswami, he can know, otherwise not. At that time, a society was established, and that society was Vishwa Vaishnava Raja Sabha. Only the translation of that is ISKCON, International Society for Krishna Consciousness. But really it was established by Rupa Goswami and Jiva Goswami. Jiva Goswami framed the rules and regulation of all that thing, and president was Rupa Goswami. So the aim and object of that Vishwa Vaishnava Raja Sabha, Krishna Consciousness internal, was same as Swamiji came to West and East, and he gave that mission. I know that in 1916, Vinod Bihari Brahmachari, our Reverend Gurudev, as a Brahmachari, very powerful, very influential, though he was a boy of 16, he went to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu land, Mayapur, and he offered himself in the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. At that time, that mission, Gaudiya mission, was very, very little.
Small.
You should excuse me for my language. I don't know English at all.
You speak
anyhow, by your all mercy, ISKCON leaders like Tamal Krishna, Giriraj Swami, and so many Govinda Maharaj in England, Shivram, all used to come and to make train in English, something like that. They forced me to speak English, but I never tried for it.
You speak the language of the heart.
So, it may be some mistake. Kindly you should excuse for that. I know that you are so much qualified to take my mood, and that will be the main thing. Prem has his own language. Yes. Devotion has his no longer. It can skin by eyes, by any mood, by hands. It is not only
words. Heart transaction.
Yes, only speaking. But it can speak by anything. Language will not disturb, it will not make problem. So, what I was telling? He met his Prabhupada on 1966 and he took
1916
and he took Harinam from him, and he joined colleges, and after some year, 3 years, he left the colleges because he used to teach the professors and principals of that colleges. So he left and came totally in the lotus feet of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati in 1919. I had known that Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, Abhay Charanar Prabhu, he came in the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada in 1922. And after that, some years he took second initiation from him. And he was at that time first in Calcutta, and then he came to Allahabad, Prayag. So from 1922, my Gurudev and he, they were bosom friends to each other. And very learned both were, very strong, never have any fear at all. They can express their thoughts very
strongly
without any fear. Also, if the President of India made any wrong thing, that Krishna has this body and also material and his soul is there, they both strongly opposed. And they challenged them, the President of India, very learned person in the whole world. So they were bosom friends from very beginning. My Guru Maharaj once came to Allahabad and he stayed with him for so long time, about 6 months with him in Allahabad. After that, you know that in 1968 he took renunciation in 59. I took renounce order in Navadvip by my Gurudev in 1954. And my name was kept Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. Narayan Maharaj. Why it was kept Bhakti Vedanta? Because Prabhupada or his disciples gave this nickname to Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. Bhaktivedanta, Abhay Charanar, Bhaktivedanta. They wanted to tell us, to teach whole world, Vedanta is not a Nirvishesha Brahmavadi Sampradaya. Vedanta has meaning bhakti cult only. So, Vedanta is a bhakti book, not Mayavadi Shastra. That is why our Gurudev first took this name of Swamiji, he was given. And we were then told Bhaktivedanta Narayan, Bhaktivedanta Trivikram, Bhaktivedanta Baman Maharaj, my elder god brothers, senior. And so many, about 26 or 27 sannyasis we are given in the name of that Bhaktivedanta. So there was so much relation in between them. At last he came to Mathura in 1958 or perhaps in that. And he lived so much time there, and I requested him. I used to make chapatis for him, so much services to him. I was mutt commander there. I used to help him in his writing books. I used to help him by my kirtan. He liked so much my kirtan. Sometimes he used to play on mridanga and I used to sing so many kirtans. Hari Hare Namah Krishna Jadavai Sri Rupa Manjari Pada Seimura Sampat. I was at that time quite young, very energetic. Also I was editor of Sri Bhagavat Patrika. Swamiji Maharaj was Sanghapati. in our two book. So there was so much familiarity between them. He accepted my praying that he should take sannyas. He took sannyas. And then he came to Delhi and Vrindavan. I was also with him. And when he managed to come to New York in America, he also invited me to come with him. But I told that I am serving my Gurudev. So I will come, I will join you, but in nick time. So he told me to help him. I helped him in sending his all books. He came with nil farthing in America. He came in not in airlines. He came in navigation, India. With so much suffering he came. You know all more than me. He began to preach in from 22nd Avenue in New York, and there is a tree in park. What park? I went there and took the feet dust of Swamiji there with hippies. When he used to recite Hare Krishna, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivas Adi Sri Gaur Bhaktavinoda, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama. The hippies began to dance on the song and make merry. Sometimes they offer wine to Swamiji, oh, take this. But all the hippies became happy.
Happy hippies?
Yes, became happy. And they became so much pure Vaishnava Rishi. And then Swamiji established ISKCON first there. And from there he preached all over his world, wrote so many books. His mission was, and object was the same as Rupa Goswami. So he is Rupanuga Vaishnava. He has written in his books that he is Rupanuga Vaishnava. He is the servant of Rupanuga Vaishnava. Rupanuga means to follow the same object and mission of Rupa Goswami. There are two things, Rupanuga and Raganuga. Not much difference in Raganuga and Rupanuga, but some difference. But this topic is so high and confidential. But yet I want to tell very little about this. What is called Raganuga? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to preach this Raganuga. What is this? Krishna is so merciful. And he is ocean of rush. So he is ocean of rush. And in the next, he is so much merciful. So he is merciful. He came to preach this Raganuga Bhakti. But how? By the means of Harinam Sankirtan. No? Harinam Sankirtan is Yuga Dharma. So Advaita Acharya can have done this. But Prem cannot be given by Advaita Acharya. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come. So anar picharing chirat karuneya vatirna kalau samarpayi tum unnato jalrasangsa bhakti shriyam harihapur sundar dyuti kadamba sandipita sada hridaya kandare spurutme sachinandana. I will explain this poem of Srila Rupa Goswami. It will take so much long time. Time has gone. completed? So we should, I will explain this very, very sweet, interesting, this poem has meaning. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has only come to bestow the sprinkles of prema bhakti. What prema bhakti? What gopis have? They are ragatmika. Ragatmik and raganug are not same. Ragatmik is only in Golok Vrindavan. Not in Golok, but in Vrindavan. Braja or Gokul. Only there. Their atma, their soul, everything depends on rag. They have natural rag, natural love, affection for Krishna. So they are ragatmika. Ragatmi of three kinds. Sakha, Vasalya, and Madhur. Sakha, Sridham, Sudham, Madhmangal, Subal, all. Vasalya Ras, Nanda, Yashoda, and all the gopis who were above 40, they are householders. All the mothers and fathers used to think that Krishna is my son, especially Nanda and Yashoda. Among Nanda and Yashoda, Yashoda has more affection for Krishna. So he is called Yashoda Nandan. He is called also Nanda Nandan, but Yashoda has more affection for and more the gopis, young gopis, like Srimati Radhika, Lalita, Vishakha and all. All are ragatmik. If anyone has greed in this world to serve Krishna in three ways, especially in the mood of gopis, then he is called araganuga. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give most important thing, the same mood of like gopis. And this is called Araga Nuga Bhakti. He has come to give this world. And to test the moods of Srimati Radhika. These are prominent reasons of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming to this world. But at that time, Yugadharma was named Sankirtan. So he gave all these things through name. Harinam Sankirtan, with love and affection. Even to animals, creepers, trees, whoever came in the sight of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who saw Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from different place, far away, they also were what? In Krishna Prem. They all became mad. Also, mad elephants, tigers, serpents, deers everywhere. When he was going to Vrindavan from Puri, everyone, charmed with the personality of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and they became all Vaishnava. There was no caste and creed. Whoever seen Chaitanya Mahaprabhu far away, they were become all Vaishnava. Even grasses, even plants and all others, deers, tigers. So, Swamiji has, but what is Rupanuga? If anyone wants, among any of the three or four same mood and to serve Krishna, they are called Raganuga. But a special mode of Rupa Goswami, he was in Krishna, time of Krishna, he was a Rupa Manjari. He was serving Radha and Krishna conjugal, but more inclined towards Srimati Radhika. He was the Dashi of Srimati Radhika. So his mood, especially those who are greed, a strong greed, to have the mood of a rup, manjaris are likewise, they are called rupanuga. No? Those who have greed to become a shevak, dasharas, or sakharas, basalyaras, they can be called rupanuga, raganuga. But especially those who want the mood of Rupa Goswami are rupanuga. So we are so much fortunate to come in the line of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. All the leaders, all the acharyas in this line, up to Swamiji, my Gurudev, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, all were rupanuga Vaishnava. Same mood. So we are also lucky so much. So we are, मैं उनके ये हैं, उन्हीं के succession में हम लोग.
We are in the same
discipline
succession. Discipline succession. Yes, yes, yes. Same. So we are entitled to have that. We are not rupanuga. We don't want this. Then you should not come in this line. Should not come. Openly, Swamiji, in his Chaitanya Charitamrita explanation, several times, not one time, several times he disclosed this thing. You can read Chaitanya Charitamrita, first four. I will try to give some narration about this. In my classes, I think that I will be here for
3 weeks.
Regular class be done, without any caste and creed. This is my party, this is his party, this is his party, not like this. I have so much honor, as for my Gurudev, to Pujyapad Sridhar Maharaj, to Swamiji, to Nemi Maharaj, to Sauti Maharaj, all these senior most associates of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. I'm so lucky and fortunate to have association of all the old and senior most sannyasis of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. At that time I was there, but not I have joined the mission, unluckily. Pujyapad Bhavan Maharaj, he is in the same age. He has seen Prabhupada and he came to Mayapur in the presence of Srila Prabhupada at the time. He came before Sridhar Maharaj joined the mutt. But he was a very little boy, very little boy. At the about the age 10 or 11 or 12.
10.
And he was ready in Bhakti Vinod Institute. But I came after that, when Prabhupada went in 37. So unluckily I could not meet Srila Prabhupada. But I am so lucky that I came in the lotus feet of my Gurudev. He was very, very much offered to Srila Prabhupada. And thus, I was telling that how Swamiji and my Gurudev were bosom friends from the beginning.
Yeah.
And I have the affection of both. Also, I want to tell you that I have helped him, Swamiji, in so many ways. When he was in preaching, also in the last date, he called me. As he told that, keeping my hands in his hands, with some tears he told that you should excuse me. My God brother should excuse me. I have done something for preaching. Not willingly. And also I want that you should help me, my all disciples. What kind of help he wanted? Money? Any intelligence? They are more intent. Something learning, they are so much learned. Not for this. I know that he was knowing that he can help in Krishna Bhakti. And the aim and object for which he came to Western and Eastern countries to bestow a sprinkle of Raganuga Bhakti or Rupanuga Bhakti. That he has written in his all books, especially in Srimad Bhagavata explanations and in Chaitanya Charitamrita explanations. In his Krishna book, he has given. I was ordered. Now I want, from beginning, I tried to obey his orders. So for not other any gain, I have come here. I have only come to give the same mission, same object, same teaching, and to help ISKCON. I know that some sincere disciples are thinking that they are now orphan, helpless. But I want to tell them that Swamiji is not dead. He is still today as he was. So be nirbhay.
Fearless.
He can help you when you will pray him. He has sent me also. I have not come to share wealth and reputation and anything, disciples. I have come only to help them. And especially the disciples of Swamiji who felt neglected. For any reason, they have left ISKCON. But they cannot leave ISKCON. I know that there is not only a sanstha ISKCON, but this mood, this object is ISKCON. And it is for ever. It is not a new thing. So I think they are all ISKCON who are adopting the mood of Swamiji, of Rupa Goswami. They are chanting and remembering. They cannot leave ISKCON. They can leave any leader, those who are not favorable. But ISKCON is a mood, is a theory. So we should think that we are not out of ISKCON. So I want to make ISKCON so strong, not to share money or anything worldly desire. They should not also fear from me. I want to go to ISKCON here. There is ISKCON perhaps.
Yes.
There are deities.
Yes. Yes. There are Krishna deities.
There is Bhakti, Bhakti Vedan Swami Maharaj.
Yes.
So I want to go. But if they will oppose and they will tell that you should not come here, then I will have to think. Otherwise, think we are all in one family, Gaur family, Gaur Parivar. I have nothing against anything, nothing. If we are associating with new one, bona fide, new one, why we have to struggle with devotees? So nothing to quarrel, nothing to make any problem for them. I have come to solve the problems. that we are all in one family, Gaur Parivar. We should not quarrel. We should solely preach, mane, sab log milkar.
Unitedly.
We should do all these things. And it should be always pure, not mixed with worldly desires and all these things. Not to be in the same class forever. Understand? Not to be in the same class where we are reading first in 40 years before.
ABCD.
Yeah. But ABCD in like arithmetic. What? Not ABCD one, but let ABC be a triangle. It's higher authority.
It's dynamic.
Yes. So gradually we should try to come what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted, what was the object of Srila Rupa Goswami he has written in his books, and try to develop our Krishna consciousness. So we have nothing to fight with anyone, no grudge to anyone, we are not enemy to anyone, we don't want money, they should keep money if they like, reputation. I am not a learned person, I am not going to argue or anything to them that I am like you. So,
it's cool.
So humbly I beg that I will hear in my these two, I will explain gradually the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the teachings of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, our disciple Guru, only this, and how we can enter in that, nothing else. We are not coming here to make any party, you don't pay. You should give honor to all who are chanting Krishna. Though who are not Madhyam or Uttam, yet you should give them respect. I used to give respect to all. Those who are in Kanishta are lower than Kanishta, even.
To all sorts.
So, I should take leave today, and next day we will meet together and discuss. You can also ask anything if you like from tomorrow. I will try to answer the questions, and thus for 3 weeks we will discuss all these things. Gaur Premana. Krishna Das.
I have announcements.
He wants to make an announcement.
You can, yes.
What is Sampradaya here?
Yes, it's like something's more than that.
Ekathan?
We can announce to them that in morning time,
decide.
We can have Mangal Arati at 6.
Okay. Mangal Arati will be at 6 o'clock here, and as Gurudev was just saying, now for the next 3 weeks, this is a mat. Go to Haribo.
Gauranga Bodhita Habe Pula
Krishna Das.
Where is Krishna Das?
Krishna Das.
You can do.